Hi, my name is Quinn Rodney, and thank you for taking part in Parks and Recreation Summer of At-Home Fun. We wanted to give everyone a chance to build and create things out of Legos, various items. Today, we'll be building this turn-of-the-century kind of style warship. Now, I don't expect you guys to build this exact same thing, but I do want to show you a few building techniques for building giant ships. Now, you can build this one with me if you want, or build your own. This one I'm basing it off of HMS Surprise, which is a warship from the early 1800s in the novel Master and Commander, and they even used a replica ship of HMS Surprise in a movie they made about that book, Master and Commander, and you can actually go to San Diego and see the actual replicant ship. And the thing I like most about it is it's got these massive cannons on the side, and it's a pretty large ship. It's a frigate, but I'd encourage you to build your own style of ship. You can have three masts, you can have two masts, you could even build a little one. The techniques will be applicable no matter what. So enjoy, and let's get to it. Okay, so to start off, you're gonna need a couple of pieces to form the base of your boat. For me, I wanna make mine fairly long. It's gonna be roughly 30 studs long on the bottom, a little bit longer overall. But to start, you're gonna need, if you're gonna follow what I'm doing, which is gonna be an 8-stud wide boat, you're gonna start with a 6-stud wide base because it's gonna come out by 2 studs as you go up. So I'm gonna start with a 6x8, a 6x6, 2 2x10s, a 2x4, another 2x4, 4x6, and a 1x2, okay? And you need to arrange them going from the front to the back. You need the 6x8 and the 6x6 to go together. And then the 2 2x10s will form here. You're gonna have a little gap in the bottom. That's by design. And then you're gonna use the 2x4 to attach the 4x6 to the 2 2x10s. And the way you're gonna do that is you're gonna take your 4x6 and you're gonna put your 2x4 right there, so it's overlapping by one. And then you're gonna put just the very corner stud of the 1 2x10 one side and the other. Now hold it together. Now the 2x4 and the 2x1, the 2x1 goes underneath the 2x4 like that. This one has holes in it. It's not necessary, any 2x1 will do, 2x4 will do, and you just stick it on the back like that. That way it's all level, okay? Next, you're gonna need as many of these as you can get. Now this kind of dictated the size of my ship. That depends on how many of these you have, because they need to run the entire length of the boat to kind of give it that curve, like it's kind of coming down and meeting underneath the water. Right here, I have 13 2x2 slopes on one side, plus one 1x2 sloped at the back, and then same on this side. You can even double up like that, but the most important thing is you have it be roughly 27 studs long. You'll notice that's not how long the rest of the boat is. That's because we want to do other details. So starting 3 studs from the end, don't count that. 1, 2, 3 studs, you're gonna start putting your slopes on. And you're gonna run them the entire length of the boat. Okay? All the way down. And if you can, try to bridge the gap between them, between your plates there with these to make it a little bit stronger. And you'll notice, if you have the same amount of these pieces as I do, that you'll have a 1-gap ledge at the end there. Okay, so it's 1, 2, 3 studs, including this piece, okay? And you're gonna wanna do that on both sides, running the entire length of the boat. That way, you'll see that the whole boat has a kind of slope to it. See how it comes up That's what we want. Now we want to do the front, which is going to be complicated because we want it to kind of come into a point like this, and we want it to kind of come up like this. So you're going to need a number of pieces to accomplish this. Some 1x3s with the slope, some 1x2s with the slope, 2x3s with the slope. What you're going to want to do is you're going to want to make this shape right here. And you can do that with 2L-shaped pieces like this, or you can use a 1x2 and a 1x4 together. Just make sure they're thin. You're going to want to place it on the front of the ship like this, so it makes like that nice point. And to kind of connect it, get one of these 2x3s and attach it on there, like so. And then you can attach it to the boat, like that. Now, you're going to want to get 4 1x2s with a slant to them. Just like that. You're gonna wanna put 2 of them in the front in the middle, like this. And then 2 on the sides, like that. Don't worry about this space because we're gonna fill that in with just plain old 1x2s, like that. You're gonna wanna put 1 on this side, 1 on this side, and then kind of bridge the gap between those two pieces with a 1x4 across. This kind of just holds the sides of the ship together a bit better. And then get a 2x3 and stick that on the very front of the boat like that. And then another 1x3 and stick it right here on the side, right there. And then another one on the other side, like that. Get continuing that shape. And then get 2 1x2s with a slant to them and put them on top of those 2x1s that we put in earlier, like that. You'll notice there's a little bit of a gap right here where you can see my finger. And you're gonna wanna get a 1x4 that's thick, and you can just fill in that gap. That way you can't see in there. And in the meantime, there's a 1x2 gap right there. So just get a 1x2 and plug that up. We want this to be completely flat up here, so when we start building our next part, it won't be a huge issue. So there we go. Actually, sorry. The 1x3s and the 1x2s, those should be switched. It should be the other way around. So the 1x2s should be in front of the 1x3s. There. So it makes a shape kind of like that. Now take a 1x3 and kind of stick it over the top of all those and kind of connect them together, leaving a 2x2 gap here at the front. And then kind of fill in the rest, just leaving a one piece gap right here and here. So I used these L-shaped 2x2s. You can use whatever piece is necessary. Use a 1x1 and a 1x2, 3 1x1s, I don't care. Just kind of cover them up like that, but leave these spots open because we're gonna be building off of those more. This is kind of just like a little platform there on the front. Now get another 2x3 and stick it on the very front of the boat. And there's a little gap there for a 1x2 that you can fill in right there, just like so. Now get a 2x2 with a slant to it in the other direction than what we're used to, and stick it right on top. We're kind of forming the part that will hold the figurehead, and I'll explain more about that when we get there. For the figurehead, I'm going to be using a little minifigure here. And to connect them, I'm going to use these snot building blocks. I'm using 2 of these, and they got a slight indent to them. You can use whatever pieces you want. Or maybe you don't want a figurehead, in which case you can kind of just get either a 2x2 brick and fill it in there. Kind of use your own imagination. Now, I got a little knight here to use as the figurehead. He's got a little sword, a little shield, a helmet. These were traditionally used to defend, were thought to defend and guide the ship when they sailed sailing ships like the one we're building. So I put him right here in the front so he can defend the ship and guide the ship to make sure the ship won't get lost. And I kind of don't like that you can kind of see his feet because he's supposed to be like a wood carving on the front. So I'm going to get two 1x3 slopes and stick them over the top like that. So if you're following along with how I'm doing it, I got a little yellow piece right here. And then it's black the rest of the way. Now I want to build the actual sides of the ship. And to start, you're going to need two more 1x2s with a slant to them and stick them on top of the end right there and there. Okay? Kind of hard to see because they're black. And then whatever color of your choosing, you can run along the sides all the way across all these. It might be a bit hard, but don't get discouraged. It just takes a lot of pieces, okay? And then you're gonna wanna run another line, and this can be any color. It doesn't have to be the color of your ship on the inside. This will be supports for the places where the cannons are. See, that piece isn't quite fitting the way it's supposed to. Ah, there we go. Now, where we go. This is the problem with using mega blocks, kids. Don't use mega blocks in your build unless you absolutely have to, because they're a pain. Okay. And before you reach the end of your build here, we're gonna put some slopes on the back. Now I'm gonna use 4 2x3s with a slant, and I'm gonna stick them on the back here on either side of that 2x4 we put in earlier. Okay, and then you're gonna put the other two on top of those. So now we got that big old slant happening there. Now you can finish running the trim, the boat along there, and do the same on the other side. It'll take more or less bricks depending on how big you want your boat. If you have a lot of those pieces, you can have a boat even longer than mine. I'm doing it that long. So now it should be 2 studs thick on either side. That'll help to strengthen the boat and to add the cannons here in a second. Next, you want to get a 1x8 and run it across those two that we just put in, those two 2x3s that we just put in right here. Now you'll notice I left a little gap here, and that's because I want to put in a little rudder. Now, a rudder helps to steer the ship, and I'm going to use this little snot building block right here, and I'm going to put a 1x2 underneath it, and then I'm going to put a thicker 1x2 on top of it to form that kind of structure, and then you can stick that over the end of the boat there, like that. And it should be perfectly level with the layer right here. And then you can get a little 1x2, or for instance, I'm using a 2x2 slope there. And you can kind of stick that on the back there. Now it kind of looks like it has a little bit of a rudder there. Now I'm gonna put some pieces here on the inside, just kind of a stack of a 1x1 and then 2, just to kind of level out the interior here. That'll be better. It doesn't have to be pretty, it's the inside, no one's gonna see it. Now I'm gonna bring over the name of the boat. See, I've gotten a 2x8 thick piece here. You can use two 2x4s like I did. And then I colored in a little name on a piece of paper and I taped it to the back there. And then that'll kind of be the name. And I want to make it kind of fancy, so I'm going to get one of these 1x8s that has a little railing on the side. I'm going to get two of those actually. And I'm going to put one underneath and one above the nameplate of the boat. Like, it kind of just makes a cool look on it. And actually, I'm going to need this to be a bit higher, so I'm going to put another 1x8, just regular 1x8 over the top. Now, you're going to need a bunch of different pieces here. Starting with two 2x4s that are thin, stack them on top of each other, and then put two 1x2s on the bottom edge, like that. So it makes that kind of a table kind of shape. And you're gonna wanna put these over the little gap where the rudder is. Next, get some 1x4s and kind of combine them into a 1x8, or if you have a 1x8, that'll work too. And I want it to kind of puff out at the back a bit, so I'm gonna get a piece that'll make a 2x10 right here. And this, I'm using two 2x3s and one 2x4, all thick. And I'm gonna kind of connect these together with a little 1x5 here. If you don't have these 1x5s like I have, then you can use basically any piece that you want to connect it together. You can use a 1x3 and a 1x2, a 1x4 and a 1x1. Whatever works for you, and just to kind of stick it together like that. And I'm gonna get a 1x6 and a 1x4 and stick that next to these. So now it should be, this whole thing should be 4 studs thick. Now I'm gonna get the nameplate we made earlier, and that's that final little stud that's sticking out there. It's gonna connect it to the name of the boat here, like so. And this is gonna go right over top here, but you'll notice we haven't quite finished building here. So we're gonna get a number of pieces together here, just to kinda run the length of the boat here. So I just put a 1x4 here, then putting a 1x2 here. It'll be fairly obvious to you at this point where to put these. So I'm putting the 1x4 across here, 1x2 right here. And I kind of want to fill in this gap here, so I'm going to put some. And I'm going to stick a 1x2 thin on either side. So just kind of make this flat as you can. I'm not going to tell you the specific parts because you may or may not have them, but just make it work with what you have. So now I'm going to take this big old piece right here that we just put together, and I'm going to stick it on the back. The nameplate sticking over the edge by one stud. See? Like that. You'll remember, if you remember, we used a 1x8 across here. So just kind of stick it on like so. And these 1x2s on the bottom should kind of go right here, and it'll kind of cover up the yellow underneath. This part will stick out, that's what we want. I want it to have kind of a bulge there because that's where the captain's cabin is. We're gonna need a little 1x2. You're gonna need two 1x2s with that slant once again. You're gonna put them right here in this gap at the front, like so. And again on the other side. And then get a 1x6 and put it in the middle, like that. These are the two we just put in, and then there's the bar. Now, we got a level surface we need to, we can build the cannons, finally. Now, I have an interesting technique for building cannons. I get a 1x2 thick with a hole in it. and I get one of these little one by one black pieces, and you can kind of stick it right in the hole. So now you get this kind of shape here. And it can be just a cylinder, or it can be kind of this cone shape. And you can use both, as I'll demonstrate. But there. Now, starting from this end, going across, just kind of start filling it in, and then leaving a two-stud gap every so often. So I started with a 2x3 brick right here, and then I do a space, and then just kind of alternate between one of those cannons. Then you can make as many cannons as you want, and a 2x2 brick. I'm only gonna put 5 on each side. You can make as many as you want, depending on what you have. And there we go. Now, you can fill in the rest. I've put a layer of yellow across the top of the cannons, and then a layer of black finally on top. And I'm doing this on both sides. Now, the reason I'm not showing myself build that is because it's kind of boring to watch someone build, and you guys probably won't have the same pieces. And in fact, I'd encourage you to use different pieces and different colors depending on what you have and what you want. Now, we're gonna need, we need to put in the bowsprit. Before I forget, this will be where the bowsprit, a kind of a mast that comes out the front of the ship, will come from. So get one of these 1x2 with a hinge and put a 1x1 underneath it. A 1x2 underneath it, and then on top, like that. And that'll be the height of a full brick. And we can put that right here on the front in the center. And then we can use 2 1x3s on either side to fill it in like that. And then get some more and just run it around the top. And then some more black. Like I said, can be a different pattern for your boat if you like, but this is the pattern I'm going with. And actually, I just decided I want this to bulge out a bit more, so I'm gonna take off these two pieces, and I'm gonna move these 1x4s out to the sides like that, so now it's 4 wide. And the reason I do this is partly because I forgot, and partly because it's never too late to start changing stuff on your build. If it's not working out, you can just take off a few pieces and adapt. Now, because I did that, there's a 2-stud gap right there, and I don't really want it, so I'm gonna take this stack here that I've made. It's made out of a 2x2 and 3 1x2s. And then I can stick that right in that gap there, and boom. And then I can just put these black pieces back on, just like, boom. Now, I wanna fill in this little gap here too, that way, because I'm gonna put windows here and I don't want you to be able to see in the boat. So I'm gonna take 2 1x6s and I connected them together and they can go across there like that. So we got our cannons in, we're pretty much done with our layers here. So we probably want to make our little design on the front. Now the reason why the front is going to be different, it's not just gonna be straight pieces going up, is because this is the part that hits the waves, and so the water would come up over the front, and you'll need holes in the side to kind of drain the water out. And old ship designers used to put little intricate designs on the front, kind of flowing all the boards towards the bowsprit and the figurehead. So to do this, I'm gonna get some more of those sloped pieces. We're just kind of playing around here. So I'm gonna take a 1x3 with a slope to it. I'm gonna put it on the side here. Let's get maybe 2 1x2s with slopes and stack them on top of each other like this. And stick that just in front of it, maybe. Just like that. And since I want it to still be strong, I'm gonna put a 1x2 across, connecting the two, like that. And then, I don't really like those studs being exposed, so I'm gonna put a 1x2 with a slope on it. And then I think I'll put another one going the other way, like that. That kind of makes a little design. Now I have one little space to go, so I think I'm gonna get another 1x3 and a 1x2. And I'm gonna stack them on top of each other, like this. And then I'll put a little bit of yellow on top, which I've been lacking. It's kind of a sloped grid piece, which is kind of fun. We're just kind of playing around on the front, not going for any design specifically. But yeah, I think that looks quite nice. And so I can do the same on the other side to make it nice and symmetrical. And boom, you can see the holes where the water flowed out. Now, while we're working on the front, we might as well do the bowsprit. You don't have to do the bowsprit the same way I did. You just kind of want it sticking out in front of the boat because that's what it's designed to do. It's designed to stick out in front of the boat and hold a big old sail up there. So what I've done is I've gotten one of these 1x1 columns here, or pillars, and I found it in brown, kind of wood colored. And since it's kind of short, I found this kind of samurai blade, and I'm gonna stick it on the end just like that. So now it's really long, but now I need a way to connect it. And not only do I need to connect it, I need to connect it at an angle. So if you remember, I put a little hinge piece there, and I got the other one right here. It's another 1x2 with a hinge, although it's angled differently. It's on the side instead of this side. And that'll connect right on there, but now, so now I just need to figure out a way to connect the bowsprit onto here. And I'm gonna use some snot building blocks for that. And here's one I'll be using. It's a little 1x1, and it's got a stud that's not on top. That's where the word snot comes from. And I'm gonna stick it right on the end here. And I'm gonna get another little 1x1 and stick it right behind it, like so. And because I don't really like those studs being exposed, I'm gonna put another one of those grid pieces on top. Now, watch, I can stick the bowsprit right onto that snot stud, and then I can take the little hinge and clip it right onto that hinge we put in earlier. So depending on your boat, you may or may not wanna put a bowsprit. I think it looks cooler when you do. I'd recommend either these hinges or the hinge that is made out of the two clips. Either will work, but there we go. All right, now I kinda wanna focus on the back now. Because the back's gonna be rather challenging to make. I constructed this kind of window design earlier, so I'll walk you guys through how to build it right now. But basically, this will go right over the back like this. So it's all being built off of a little 1x4 slab. And so I'm gonna start with a 1x4 slab, and then I'm gonna take a big 1x4 brick and stick it right on top. I'm gonna overhang it by a little bit. Now I'm gonna get three 1x2s, like so, and I'm gonna connect them together to a big column, and I'm gonna stick that on the other side, just like so. So now it's 6 wide instead of 4 wide. And then I'm gonna take some 1x1s and stick them on the end of the 1x4 that we put on. And then I'm gonna make the top one black, because just like the rest of the boat, it's got black on the bottom, black on the top. Black on the bottom, black on the top. Now, I wanna get, since they're kind of the wrong height, and I wanna do something a little fancy up here, you're gonna need some 1x2s, two of them, and you're gonna wanna stick them on top. Or if you kinda wanna hide it, then you can kinda put them underneath. It kinda makes it a bit more symmetrical. There. So now it's not quite the right height, but that's okay, that's part of the design. Let's see. So that's gonna go right on there, like that. So now, I wanna get a 2x4 and stick it right on top, like so, of the yellow columns. And I'm gonna use a 1x2 to connect it right here. It's kinda like a window sill there. And this part that's sticking out will connect it back to the deck of the boat. And to kind of reinforce it a bit, I'm gonna get a 1x2 with the bite taken out of it, the L-shaped piece, and I'm gonna stick it here. I'll take it off so you can see better. I'm gonna stick it right here, leaving this corner undone like that. And then I'll stick it right back on top. And then most ships have lanterns on the back, so I'm gonna put a little lantern right here with a see-through 1x2 orange piece and then a flat 1x2 red piece on top. See? Now I got two of them, and I'm gonna put one on this side over that four stud piece that's sticking out on the sides here, and then again here. Now it's time to put the deck on. Now I have this big old piece right here. It's an 8x8 and it's thick. I suspect that many of you don't have a piece like this, and if you don't, that's okay. You can make it out of a bunch of 2x4s and 2x8s. Any way you need to get it done, I'm sure you can figure it out. And that'll just go right on the top here. So if you don't have a big old piece like that, you can get a couple of 2x4s, kind of run it across here, like this. But since I'm lucky enough to have that piece, I'm gonna put it in the front there. There we go. And then I'm gonna get two more 8x8 panels, and I'm gonna stick them right on here. These ones are thin, right? Which is important because in a ship as big as a frigate, usually the front of the boat is slightly raised, and so is the back. That way the people in the front of the boat can look out for stuff this way, and the captain of the boat can see as well. And then everyone who's walking around on the mid deck is kind of below, they're not blocking anybody's view. There we go. Now I kind of want to build some stairs up here. So I'm gonna get a bunch of pieces here, and to help reinforce it, I'm gonna get two more 1x6s and stick them in here to make some support. And let's see, I'm gonna make a little structure here. There's a 4x8 space here that I gotta fill in, so I'm gonna get a 2x4 and stick it on this side, and then I have two 2x6s that I can use to fill in the rest of the space here and here. And then on top of that, I have two more 2x4s to stick up here. You can kind of see the structure here. And okay, here. And I'm gonna stick a 2x8 on top. So now I got this kind of stair leading up here, and if you have it stick out a little bit right here like I did with those 2x4s I put here, the 2x4s from the windows will kind of lock in there, and it'll kind of hold that structure together just a little bit better. And with something as fancy as this, you're going to need a lot of support to keep it safe. So if you drop it, it's less likely to break into 1,000 pieces and more like 3 pieces, which is a lot easier to put together. Now, finally, I have the windows in the back. So I found this little shutter door here. It kind of looks a bit old style, and I can stick that right on the back here. And then I got this L-shaped bracket here. It's made out of a 2 1x2s with the hinges, and I've just turned them so that it's at a 90 degree angle, like this. And I've gotten two of them, and I can kind of put those on either side. So now it kind of looks like there's one big window here, smaller windows here, and then a really small window here in the corner. You can do it however you like. If you have a specific ship you're building off of, a lot of ships have different designs for the windows and the captain's quarters on the back. So now we need to build the deck above the captain's quarters. Now this is actually surprisingly complicated, but it doesn't have to be. I'm getting a 1x4 on top of it, then the 1x8 there, and then I'm getting a 6x8, and I'm putting it on top of all that. So it'll go across the 2x4s on the windows, the 1x8 we just put on, the 1x8 that's a part of the stairs. There we go. Now we got the whole deck done, just like that. And it's really starting to take shape. It's kind of got this kind of sweeping shape to it, which is perfect because that's kind of what you want on a boat. So the water will flow in and the captain can see up here and the people in the front can see back here. But if you've ever been on a boat, you know it's kind of rocky, kind of slippery, so you're gonna need some railings along the sides and even on the back. So just kind of get kind of sweeping looking pieces and just kind of run them along. So I'm using a bunch of thin pieces. Doesn't matter how long they are, they just need to fill in your deck. I'm not using full pieces here because I don't want it to be a full thickness piece. I don't want it to be this big old piece sitting on the front. I just want it to be just, you know, railings that you can still see over. And then I got these kind of sloping pieces that are 1x4 in size, and I've made it so it can kind of sweep along there. Make the deck just a little bit more smoother. Ships have complex shapes to them, so the crazier looking pieces, the better. I'm gonna take this is a 1x6 with a real smooth slope to it, which I really like. I can damage the side here when I accidentally flip the boat. But there. And once again, just be symmetrical, really. That's the key to making it look good. So I'm gonna get little fan type pieces here and here. Gonna stick a railing there. Now this piece is kind of interesting. I made it myself out of just a few random pieces. I'll show you how to build it real quick. It's just a little fin piece, a 2x3 fin piece with a L-shaped 2x2 on there, and then a 1x2 on the back, and then another one of these sweeping 1x4 pieces. And it can kind of go along the back here. I've made one for each side. And actually, I kind of want a bit of an overhang back here, so I'm going to move the whole deck back by one. This will kind of just give the whole thing a little bit more space. It's a bit more room. Kind of felt weird to have all this overhang and not have it overhang on the top. So now I can kind of that out, and the fins even go over the lanterns, which kind of looks nice if you ask me. So now I'm gonna put this 1x8 piece on the back, like so. I'm gonna get another 1x8 piece, this time a different color. Stick it on here, a 1x3 with a slope to it. Do that on both sides, maybe a 1x2 in the middle, like that. And then a 1x4 flat piece on top. Then I kind of feel like it should go back even more, so I'm gonna kind of craft a kind of an interesting piece here. I got two of these 2x2 L-shaped pieces, and I'm putting it on either side of just a plain 2x2, and then I'm getting a 2x4, one of these, I've forgotten the name, and I'm gonna connect it all together like that. And then I can kind of stick this up underneath the overhang like that. And then I want one more kind of lantern torch up here. So I'm gonna get, since I want it to be in the center, I'm gonna get one of these 1x2s with one stud on top and stick it right in the center of it. I'm gonna get, it's kind of like a telescope looking piece, and I'm gonna stick it right here. And then there's these two see-through 1x1s. One's yellow, one's orange, and I can kind of stick it together, and then it kind of looks like a flame. And I can put that on top, and it kind of looks like a little torch, a little lantern on the back there. Now, for the wheel, I found this little gear, and I kind of made a little structure to hold it. If you don't have a gear like that, then I would recommend you can use a vehicle steering wheel and stick it right on there. whatever works for you, whatever you think looks best. You can even get a couple of these, which we'll be using later on for the sails, and you can stick one of them on a structure similar to this. For those of you who do want to follow my build exactly, you'll have to get one of these, and I got a 1x2 there and a 1x2 there, except this one has a hole in it, and I've stacked them up. Then I got this little peg that go Technic peg. One plugs into that hole, and the other has a little Technic axle adapter to it, which will adapt it so this gear can fit right on there. And then you can stick it on the boat like so. Now for the sails. Now the sails are, you can make them however you like. I'm gonna use some brown 2x2s. I'm gonna start with a 2x2 that's perfectly square, and then the rest here are kind of round. I've connected 6 of them together here, and then I'm gonna stick a little Technic axle in the top there, so it's sticking out. And then I'm gonna get, these are 1x10s, and I'm gonna connect them together here with a 1x4, like that, and this can kind of be the crossbar. Now to connect it onto this Technic axle, I'm gonna get a 1x2 that has a little axle piece in there, and I'm gonna stick it on the middle there, and stick it over the top there. Next, I'm gonna use some 1x8s. Do the same thing, connect them together with a 1x4, and then a 1x2 with an axle adapter on there. Although I wanna make this a little bit taller, so I'm gonna connect together 6 more of these 2x2 columns, cylinders, whatever you wanna call them. I'm gonna stick it on top like this. And then, since I don't have a Technic axle that's as long as I like, I'm gonna connect 2 of them together with this little handy dandy piece, specifically made to connect them together. And I've made another crossbar, this time with 2 1x6s connected together by a 1x4. And then I can put the other one we made just now right underneath. And I can stick that all right on top. And you can do a similar thing in the front and in the back. Or you can just have one sail, one mast, or you can have 2 masts, whatever you want. I encourage you to make your own boat, make it your own, however you like. If you like boats with 2 masts, go for it. If you like one with 5 masts, go for it. I won't stop you. I want to see what you guys can make with these shipbuilding skills that I just shared with you. Try using my cannon building technique, my window building technique, the name on the back, and especially the way of sloping the front of the boat to give it that curvature that most boats have. So there you go. I hope you enjoyed. Stay safe, stay healthy, stay inside. Thank you. Okay.